Question to Brother Imran from the sister's mic.
The Bible says that the name of God is Jehovah. Jehovah. In Quran, the name of God is not given. Allah means only God. How can the book of this nameless God be the word of God?
Sister, thank you very much. You have asked a very important question that time did not permit me to discuss in my lecture. Jazakallah khair, sister. Thank you very much. But before I again give the answer, sir is not bothered who wrote it, because sir does not know who wrote it. No Christian on the face of the earth knows who wrote those books. They give it the name of Prophet Joshua, Prophet Joseph, Judah, Jacob. 100 names they give, but there is not a single authentic evidence to prove that truly they wrote it. The original manuscripts that the Christian world today boasts of. They say, we have got the original manuscripts. What are the original manuscripts? They say written in Hebrew, in Greek. So when were they written, sir? They say they were written at the time of Jesus. I already challenged. I said at the time of Jesus, not even a doodle was put. Scratch. Dot. An iota. Full stop. Nothing. No comma. Nothing. When was it written? According to all the authentic sources, the original manuscripts that the Christians have today can be dated back 300 years after Jesus Christ, may peace be upon him. Not before that. The most original authentic sources for Christian scriptures are the Vatican Codex, the Sinaitic Codex, and the Alexandrian Codex. Alexandrian Codex belongs to the 5th century. The Vatican and the Sinaitic, according to them, to the 4th century, early 4th century. Who wrote it down? Nobody knows it. So therefore, nobody is bothered. According to your own logic, sir, I'm telling you, according to your own logic, when you were discussing the case of incest, you gave a beautiful explanation to the people and you said, see, if the child is born with another face of the neighbor's face, it becomes a problem. So identity of the child becomes so much important. Identity of the word of God is not important. Identity of the child, who is the true father, becomes so important. But the identity of the word of God, whoever writes it, no problem. We are ready to take it wholesale. And thank you very much, sir, for considering my pain that I took to write down the chart. I took it with sincere devotion and prayer to Allah that if that would have made you to understand the truth, I would have been the most honorable person on earth today. But it's all Allah. فَذَكِّرْ إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مُذَكِّرْ لَسْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِمُسَيْطِرٍ. My job is only to convey you and to convey everybody. I'm not here to convert anybody. I'm here to convey. The hidayah comes from there. If Allah wills, you will come forward before you leave to read La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, inshallah. And coming to the question posed by sister, the name of the God in the Bible is Jehovah or Jehovah, Yahweh or Jehovah. But in the Quran, it's only Allah. Sister, the word J is a Latin word. It's neither Greek nor is it Hebrew. Alphabet J, Jehovah, J is Latinized version of the name Yahweh. Yahweh, what is Yahweh? So they say Yahweh is the Almighty God. Does Yahweh mean the Almighty God? They say no. Then what is the name? If you open the Bible, if you read your Hebrew text, sister, it's Elohim. Eloh, Arabic Ilah. Eloh, Ilah. Why im there? In Hebrew language, I am is added to a name or any other word to give more respect to it. Eloh, Elohim. Eloh, Hebrew and Arabic are sister languages, very common to each other. Ilah, Eloh. Yahweh, Yahayun. We call Allah Yahayun, Yahweh. Eloh, Ilah. The confusion came into the minds of the people previously when they were calling only God. Who is the God? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it clear. Qul, My son read it.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Qul huwallahu ahad.
My son read it for all of you. He conveyed the message to all of you. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Surah Ikhlas, surah number 112, ayah number 1, 2, 3 and 4. Qul, they are asking you, who is the God? Say to them, huwallahu ahad. He is Allah, the only one God. Allahu samad. He is independent. My daughter translated it. He is independent. He does not depend upon anyone. Allahu samad. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. He has no parents. He does not beget children. It's a human work. It's a lower animal function to beget children. God doesn't do it.